奉主耶稣圣名，我们继续来学习约翰福音。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we will continue our studies with the book of John.
我们不知道昨天的课之后有没有什么问题。
I don't know if anyone has any questions after yesterday's classes.
如果都没有问题的话，我们就继续了。
And if you don't have any questions, then we will continuing on.
请 AV 把那个投影投在约翰福音的分段第四。
And so, please, audio and video, can you project the slide number four?
就是在那个大纲的地方的第四点。
And this is around the outline, the fourth bullet point.
他们有人在那里吗？有。我们如果昨天看的那个约翰福音的大纲哈。
And so, if we review the outline of Gospel John,
就是从第一章一到十八节这是主耶稣从父那里来。
And so chapter 1 from 1 to 14, Jesus came from the Father.
然后之后他就进入了世界。
And then he entered into the world.
他行神迹，他给教训。
He performed miracles and then he gave teachings.
之后他就准备要离开世界。
And then he was prepared to leave the world.
回到父那里去。
To return back to the Father.
所以从一到十二章就是一个很大的段落。
So, from chapter 1 to 12 is a big section.
那这里面有七个记号。
And there are seven marks within.
那这个记号我们中文都把它翻作神迹。
And the marks in Chinese we call it miracles.
这个记号在约翰福音这个记号是专门主给主耶稣用的而已。
And so this mark in the Gospel John is specially prepared for the use of Lord Jesus Christ.
也就是说，这就是特别要去让读的人可以了解，这就是证明耶稣就是从父那里来的。
In other words, this is allowed the reader to comprehend that Lord Jesus Christ indeed came from the Father.
所以你如果看约翰福音第十章
，If you turn to Gospel John chapter 10,
在第四十一节
，and verse 41,
约翰福音第十章四十一节
，Gospel 10, Gospel John chapter 10 verse 41,
这是有关于主耶稣讲到有关施洗约翰，主耶稣讲特别讲到施洗约翰呢
，and here Jesus specially talked about John the Baptist,
那。因为主耶稣回到约旦河那边去嘛，
And so Lord Jesus Christ returned back to River Jordan.
有许多人第四十一节，到他那里，他们说，约翰一件神迹都没有行过，但约翰指着这个人所说的一切话都是真的。
For then many came to him and said, John performed no sign, but all the things that John spoke about this man were true.
其实约翰约翰。但如果你看其他的福音书其实约翰做很多，施洗约翰做很多事的。
Actually, if you read the other gospel books, John had done many things.
但是在这里特别提到说，约翰连一件神迹都没有行过。
But here recorded that John has not performed one single miracle.
因为这里的神迹指的是记号，是专门指的主耶稣的。
And because the miracles described in this book is specially for Jesus only.
那这个就是。在约翰福音里面的神迹就是一个记号，就是这是一个标志，你看到这个你就知道他是谁这样。
And so all the marks represented in the Gospel of John, once you see it, you will know who it is for.
好，那在这里面这一段里面都特别写到门徒他们想起来。
And here in this section recorded that the disciple remembered.
二章二十二节
Chapter 2 verse 22.
二章二十二节
，Chapter 2 verse 22。
所以到他从死里复活以后，那门徒就想起他说过这话，便信了圣经和耶稣所说的了。
Therefore, when he had risen from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this to them, and they believed the scripture and the word which Jesus had said.
这是有关于这个圣殿啊，圣殿被拆毁，那三天要重建。
This was related to the discussion about the temple being destroyed, and after the third day it would be rebuilt.
二十一节，主耶稣这话是以他的身体为殿说的。
And verse 21, but he was speaking of this temple, of this body.
所以圣殿啊，这个殿是耶稣的身体。
So the temple is the body of Jesus.
哦，所以这个殿呢，就不是物质的殿，是属灵的。
So this temple is not a physical temple, but
那我们说，我们说教会是圣殿。
And we say that church is the temple.
它是属灵的。
And it is spiritual.
所以这个殿呢？主耶稣的身体是只有一个。
So the temple there's only one.
那主耶稣是从天上来的。
So Lord Jesus Christ came from heaven.
他虽然在地上，但是也在天上。
Although he's in the world, but he's also in heaven.
所以教会一定是独一的。
And so the church has to be independent.
是在天上属灵的。
It's on in heaven and it's spiritual.
现在在地上。
On earth.
那现在。这个就是、这个教会的先存性，就是在创立世界以前，这个教会就存在的。
And so before the creation of the heaven and earth, the church existed.
那所以既然是基督的身体，所以这个教会啊，其实就是固定的，因为主耶稣的身体啊，他从创世以前选召什么样的人进入他这个身体是固定的了。
Although this is the body of Christ, but creation of the world, he had pre-selected who's going to be in this body.
所以主耶稣的身体其实不会变胖了。
So the body of Jesus Christ will not be fat.
我们说教会的增长，我们说教会增长本身的意思是说，把凡是主神借着耶稣基督所要拣选的人都把他传进来到教会里面来了。
When we say the growth of the church, it really means that all the chosen people of Lord Jesus Christ has been selected and brought inside of the church.
那我们里面已经在主里面的人，每一个人的灵性都增长了。
And so each and every single one of us inside this church, we have grown spiritually.
所以真正的教会增长是我们里面属灵的这个品质哈，真的越来越像耶稣了。
So the quality and the growth of the church is really representative of our spiritual qualities to be more like Christ.
让这个基督的身体这个殿哦能够荣耀，然后让世人可以看到耶稣的名。
So the Christ and the body of Christ and this temple allowed the people to see and glorify His name.
那这也是我们今天真教会的使命。
This is also the mission of True Jesus Christ.
我们是要复兴使徒时代的那个完美的主所建立的那个圣灵教会的教会。
And we're here to revive the church of the apostolic times and the perfect church.
让我们都能够真的像主的门徒一样，充满能力，充满爱心，又能够去很努力执行天父所交付的使命。
And we can truly indeed be like the disciples of Lord Jesus. They have strength and faith, and to really execute the mission that was entrusted to them.
好，那第十二章的第十六节又一次想起来了。
And chapter 12 verse 16, once again they remembered.
第十六节，十二章十六节。
Chapter 12 verse 16.
这是主耶稣他进耶路撒冷最后。准备要被钉十字架的前夕了。
And this is when Jesus Christ entered into Jerusalem. This was pre-crucifixion.
他是骑着驴驹进耶路撒冷的。
And he rode in with on a donkey.
十六节，这些事门徒起先不明白，等到耶稣得了荣耀以后才想起来，这话是指着他写的，并且众人果然像他这样行了。
十六节，
十二章十六节。
十二章十六节。And his disciples did not understand these things at first, but when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things was written about him and that they had done these things to him.
That 他们跟从主耶稣。其实主耶稣讲很多，他们当时都不明白的。
And so originally they did not understand many of the things that Jesus have said.
等到耶稣得荣耀以后，他们就想起来了。
After Jesus Christ received the glory,
they remembered. 就是主耶稣被钉十字架了。
And after Jesus was nailed on the cross,
他被举起来。
He was exalted.
他就吸引了很多人到他这里来了。
He attracted many people to him.
啊，所以这个主耶稣第三十二节哈，第三十二节他自己说。
And verse 32 says,
我若从地上被举起来，就要吸引万人来归我。
And
32节。
And I, if I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself.
那这个他这个荣耀就显现出来了。
And so his glory was revealed.
所以这个主耶稣得荣耀，就是他被钉十字架以后啊。
So after Jesus Christ was nailed on the cross,
那这个他的门徒又想起他的话来了。
His disciple remember what he said.
那我们知道，主耶稣升天之后，让圣灵都降下来，应许圣灵都降下来了。
And they knew that after Jesus ascended to heaven, a Holy Spirit, a promise of Holy Spirit came.
所以这个圣灵的功用会让我们想起，会明白主所说的话语。
The effects of the Holy Spirit will allow us to remember. The things that Lord Jesus Christ.
当主还在世上在传福音，在执行这个救恩的工作的时候
，And when Jesus Christ was preaching the gospel in this world, executing the mission,
讲了很多话
，And he has said many
things. 那门徒不明白
，And the disciple did not know.
包括玛利亚，他也不明白主耶稣讲的话。
Also included Maria, Mary did not know what.
但是他都把它放在心里先想。
But they place it in their hearts and remember.
以后就明白了。
And later on, they will comprehend.
这个其实也今天我们的原则。
So this is our principle today.
我们在读圣经。
When we read the Bible,
我们读明还不明白了。
Any parts that were unclear,
就不要先去怀疑了。
And do not have any doubts.
先放着。
And just place it aside.
祷告。
Pray.
当圣灵感动我们的时候
，When the Holy Spirit moves us,
你就会明白。
And you will understand.
比如说。
For example,
现在有人不明白说为什么耶稣教是唯一得救的教会。
And many people don't understand that why Jesus Church is the only church.
就很多人说很棘手，为什么你可以这样？你要这样讲，你这样讲不是别人都不敢来信的吗
？And many people would say that. Why would you say this? Because other people would not come to your church this way.
这个其实是因为我还不明白了。
And because you don't understand.
那这个时候先放着。
At this time, you set
aside. 要去听。
And you will listen.
然后要祷告。
You have to pray.
要从真理里面去走下手。
And you have to go from the.
然后要从教会到底是怎么一回事去看清楚。
And you have to see what a church is really like.
教会不是我们人定义的。
And this is not something that we can critique on.
教会是基督的身体。
And the church is the body of Christ.
是从天而降的。
It's from coming down from heaven to the world.
所以教会这几个必要条件不是我们人定出来的。
So the basic criteria qualification of church is not established by men.
不是说我们人先定了几个标准，然后我们这个教会符合这个标准，所以我们是真教会，不是这样子吗
？And it's not because that few people have set some standards or rules, and this will be the main standard.
教会一定是在天上。
And the church has to be in heaven.
从父在那边，父那边存在的。
And it's existed with the Father.
因为是耶稣的身体。
And because this is the body of Christ.
那不懂先放着。
So if you don't understand, you just place it down and pray.
以后一定会明白。
And then you would definitely understand in the future.
因为真理一定是越来越清楚的。
Because the truth must be clearer.
这个就是这个门徒他们后来才想起来。
And so this is how the disciples remember later on.
那第十章你看第十章。
And let's turn to chapter 10.
第六节。
Verse 6.
这是主他现在用羊牧羊人的经验然后说他是牧者会走在前面那个羊会听他的声音他会认识他的羊
And Jesus using his example as a shepherd that he will walk in front of the flock and then his sheep would know him and he would know his sheep
第六节说耶稣将这个比喻告诉他们但他们不明白所说的是什么意思
Verse 6 Jesus used this illustration but they did not understand the things which he spoke to them
你看这里又不明白了
So here they did not understand again
连比喻都没明白了你说还有什么可以明白的
And so they didn't even understand any parables what possibly things they can understand
那所以这里羊这个主耶稣这里要说他是门
And so Jesus called himself the gate.
那他是门，但是他又是那个牧人。
And he's also the shepherd.
所以他现在用比喻说了。
And so this is being said in a parable.
那这个就好像说我是什么，我是什么，这个就是相对性的宣告。主耶稣是什么， 这个应该都是门徒当时候他们可以明白，很容易明白的，生活上就可以有的经验，就可以知道说他在讲什么。
And so this is the same proclamation as I am. So disciple knew him from the life, and then they would know what he is talking about.
所以这个就是主耶稣在教训门徒的时候。
And so this is when the Lord Jesus Christ is teaching the disciples.
主用很多的方法。
At this time, he used many ways to teach the disciples.
可是不见得明白。
But not necessarily they understand.
那这个时候主耶稣像老师。
From the, at this time, Jesus is like a teacher.
门徒就像学生。
And disciples are like students.
或者有时候主耶稣像主人，这个门徒就像仆人一样。
Or sometimes Jesus Christ is like a master, and then the disciples like servants.
所以你如果看第四章。
And if you turn to chapter 4.
第四章。
Chapter 4.
他们不是走路走到累了吗
？And they were tired from walking.
好，那个时候第八节。
And at this time, verse 8.
到那个雅各井那边去休息啊，结果那门徒通通进城买食物去了。
And they went to the, they were taking a break at the well of Jacob, but the disciples had gone away to buy food.
因为其实他们来到这个叙加城是很特别的。
And so coming,
他们可能没有机会。来，如果主耶稣没有带他们，他们大概也不会来。
And coming to this Sychar city, it's a very rare opportunity because they don't normally come.
因为他们本来就犹太人，他们不会去撒玛利亚地的啦。
And because the Jews would not go to a land of Samaria.
那他们现在要买食物，他们是一堆十二个人去呢。
And so when they go and buy food, they're going in.
如果是我们的话，我们现在走路走到累得要命，然后在井旁边休息。你说要买食物，那留主耶稣一个在那里，然后他们全部都走光了，需要这样子买食物吗
？Can you imagine that we've been walking for a very long time? Everybody is resting by the well, and then the whole group of people went and buy food and left Jesus there alone.
可是说，当时门徒他们其实来到这个地方，一方面他们也很可能很害怕，说，哎，这里人对犹太人不友善。
And so maybe the disciples were also afraid that the people here is not so friendly to Jews.
那主耶稣就你们通通去，你们通通去，对不对
？And so Jesus said that you can all go.
都去，那主耶稣自己留下来。
And so he will remain behind.
因为他知道接下来要发生什么事了。
Because he knew what was about to happen.
因为接下来这个妇人就来打水。
And then the woman would come to draw water.
就展开这一段对话。
And then they had this conversation.
那所以。这个时候的那个门徒、哦、他们是跟在主耶稣旁边，像仆人啊，就反正老师肚子饿，大家也肚子饿啊，就准备食物应该的。
And so the disciples are kind of like servants following their master Jesus. If the master is hungry, obviously they have to prepare food.
那这些门徒后来都跟主耶稣一起住了。
And then later on, the disciples all live with Jesus.
所以一开始从第二章。从第一章我们就看到同住了，门徒就跟耶稣同住。
And so from chapter one we can see that they were living together.
从两个开始。
From two.
第二章、第一章那里。
Chapter one.
第三十九节。
Verse 39.
他们看完了这两个就跟主耶稣同住了。
And the two disciples started to live with Jesus.
然后接下去这些门徒、哦、至少这十二个使徒都跟主耶稣一起住。
And then all the disciples, all 12 of them, started to live with Jesus.
主走去哪里，他们就跟去哪里了。
Wherever Jesus went, they followed.
对不对？那这个就是他们是跟在主耶稣后面、哦、在学习，那也在听道理，主耶稣在训练他们。
So they were following Jesus, and then they were also being trained by Jesus.
好，这样的一个格式、哦到了十三章以后就完全不一样了。
And so this model changed after chapter 13.
那所以我们说十三章这个逾越节的晚餐设立圣洗脚礼，这个就是这个转捩点。
And so chapter 13, this was the dinner of the Passover feast.
因为主耶稣说
foot washing.
主耶稣说他知道他的时间时候到了。
And Jesus knew that his time is near.
现在父已经他知道第三十三章的第一节是说。知道自己离世归父的时候到了。
Chapter 13, verse 1, he knew that the hour had come that he should depart from this world.
在约翰福音里面有很多这个时候的问题。
And the in the Gospel of John, there are many problems with time frame.
就是有这个描述，就是有关于时候到了。
And there are many explanations of timeline.
这个时候，这是一个好像一个时机一样哈。就是什么时候该做什么事情。
And so everything is chronologically written that you have to do certain things at a certain time.
你看要不要上耶路撒冷去？
Whether they have to go to Jerusalem.
节期的那像祝棚节
，the feast.
那主一般世人说那应该去啊。
And of course you have to go.
但是主就不是这样子。
But the Lord is not this way.
他那个时候其实是都是天父指示的。
And at the time he was under the instructions of Father.
现在他知道他离世归父的时候到。
And now that he knew that the hour had come, that he would leave the world.
好，那他就开始，你看在这个时候为门徒洗脚。
And so at this time he gave foot washing.
接下去
to the disciples.
你就看到主耶稣跟门徒一系列的教导了。
And later on you will see a whole series of teachings.
十三章以后，你看到这些教导都是跟门徒讲的。
And you see after chapter 13, all the teachings are directly to the disciple.
那他现在要比如说第十三章的第三十一节，特别跟他说，你现在人子得荣耀，神在人子身上也得了荣耀了。
So especially in chapter 13, verse 31, now the Son of Man is glorified, and God is glorified in him.
32节说，神要因自己荣耀人子，并且要快快的荣耀他。
32, if God is glorifying him, God will also glorify him in himself.
还有不多的时候，
and,
我跟你们同在。
And there are, I shall be with you a little while longer.
你们要找我，但是我要去的地方你们不能到。
You will seek me where I'm going, you cannot come.
你看，现在本来同住的根据走去哪里就根据哪里。现在主说，我现在要去的地方你们不能去的了。
They were living together, but now he states that wherever he's going, that they cannot follow him.
那现在这个时候，你看主耶稣把很多事情都预先跟他们讲
，at this time,
都先讲清楚了，怕他们误会了。
Jesus foretold the things that was about to happen, so that they could understand.
他说先预告会什么会发生什么事情。
He foretold that.What would happen later on?
因为接下去就是得荣耀，就是耶稣要受苦，他要被钉十字架。
And because he's about to receive glory, and he will suffer and be nailed on the cross.
十四章的二十九节。
Chapter 14, verse 29.
十四章二十九节。
Chapter 14, verse 29.
现在事情还没有成就，我预先告诉你们，叫你们到事情成就的时候就可以信了。
And now I have told you before it comes, and when it does come to pass, you may believe.
哦、所以现在这个就是所谓是预言、哦、预告。那这个事情发生以后应验了以后，你就知道说哦，他每一句话都是真的。
So this is when Jesus foretell what's going to happen in the future, and when it does happen, you realize that everything is true.
然后三十节就说了
，And verse 30,
以后不再和你们多说话了，因为这世界的王将到，但是他在我里面是毫无所有。
I will no longer talk much with you, for the ruler of this world is coming, and he has nothing in me.
哦，那这个就是你看主耶稣的心哦，完全都是在都是天父的事情了，神国的事。
You can think, you can see the heart of Jesus Christ is indeed on the matter of heaven.
这世界的王哦，在耶稣的心里面毫无所有。
And the king
没有任何的空间让他住的。
The king of the world.Cannot do anything, has nothing in Jesus.
哦，我们今天要为什么说要追求像有主耶稣的心呢
？And so, why do we need to pursue a heart of Lord Jesus?
当我们如果像主一样啊
，If we can be on the like the Lord,
这个世界的王在我们里面没有什么地方可以站立得住。
The King of the world has no place inside our hearts.
我们如果真的像主耶稣一样，我们内心都会关心神的家。
If we truly indeed like Jesus, our inner hearts really care for the matters of church.
弟兄姐妹啊。
We care about brothers and sisters.
他不会只是一直为自己打算。
And we would not only calculate and care about ourselves.
这个世界的王，他用什么手段让我们的人离开神？
And so what kind of tactics does the king of the world use for
us to leave? 他就一直让我们看到自己啊，我自己很重要。
Because they will allow you to see yourself as important.
我的需要。
Your needs.
哇，我的感觉。
Your feelings.
No, 所以别人讲话讲不好，我感觉不好，我就要怎样
？And so if other people spoke badly of you, then you have a bad feeling, and I have to take action.
所以世界跟世界上的事是什么？肉体的情欲、眼目情欲、今生的骄傲。
And so this the pride of the world, the lust of the flesh, and lust of the eyes.
这个就是在约翰一书讲的是一样是作者，同样作者他说的。
And so this is the same author recorded in 1 John.
所以这世界的王有他的手段。
And so the king of the world would have his tactics.
就是要夺去人的心。
And it's to rob the heart of men.
那这个如果我们不小心，我们很容易就陷下去了。
If we're not careful enough, we will sink.
但主耶稣说，他在我里面毫无所有。
And but Jesus said that he has nothing in me.
那所以现在这个就是主耶稣他特别先说清楚，把事情先说清楚，让他们先准备。
And so Jesus is stating things clearly, to prepare, for them to.
因为接下来他们遇到苦难的。
And because they will, encounter afflictions later on.
好，你如果看第十六章。
Chapter 16,
25节
verse
25. 16章25节
Chapter 16, verse 25.
这些事我是用比喻对你们说的，时候将到，我不再用比喻对你们说了，乃是要将父明明的告诉你们了。
These things I have spoken to you in a figurative language, but the time is coming where I no longer speak to you in a figurative language, but I will tell you plainly about the Father.
所以以前呢，让人用比喻嘛，
So everything was figurative before. 就
是，但是现在他不再用比喻，他要明说。
But now it's not going to be figurative anymore.
因为接下去这些真理绝对不能够搞错的。
Because the truth has to be absolutely clear.
所以这些使徒，他们要对主耶稣所讲的话非常清楚的。
And so the disciple must be understand clearly what Jesus Christ was
saying. 因为主耶稣离开之后，接下去这个救恩，这个教会。真理，这个就是由使徒来负责的。
Because after the departure of Lord Jesus Christ, the responsibility of overseeing this church and salvation will be onto the disciples.
他们要把主耶稣的话，把它了解以后，把它讲出来，成为一个教训，因为以后的人他听不到耶稣讲的话了。
And they must understand the words spoken by Jesus Christ and put it into practical teaching, because later on they would not have this chance anymore.
就是。后来这信的人就没有办法听到耶稣讲的。
And they would not be able to hear what Jesus had said.
完全是根据使徒所讲的而已。
And so this is totally, based on what disciple says.
所以现在主对门徒特别说，我现在要明明的告诉你们，讲清楚。
And so, he clearly told them that he has to clearly state this to them.
29节。
Verse 29.
你看，门徒说，如今你是明说，不用比喻了。
His disciples say to him, "See, now you are speaking plainly and not using no figure of speech."
好，那个三十节说，现在我们晓得你凡事都知道，也不用人问你，因此我们信你是从神出来的。
30. Now we are sure that you know all things and have no need that anyone should question you. By this, we believe that you came forth from God.
好，那耶稣说，现在你们信吗
？Jesus answered them, "Do you now believe?"
三十二节。看哪，时候将到，且是已经到了，其实就是现在就是时候，而且继续进行着。
Verse 32, indeed the hour is coming, and yes, he has now come. So now the hour is here, and then it will continuing on.
这跟第四章所讲的是一样的。
And this is the same recording as chapter 10.
那接下去你们要分散，各归各的地方去，留下我独自一人。他说，其实不是我独自一人，因为有父与我同在。
And that you will be scattered each to his own and will leave me alone. And yet I am not alone because the Father is with me.
主耶稣知道门徒他们的心，他知道门徒软弱。
Jesus knew the heart of the disciples and how weak they are.
就像彼得跟主耶稣拍胸脯，最后还是否认耶稣。
And just like when Peter beating on his chest and later on he still refused, Jesus.
所以主他其实他看透人的心呢。
And the Lord actually see through a man's heart.
但是他第三十三节说，我告诉你们，你不用担心，我已经胜了世界。重点是他胜了世界。
In verse 33, these things I have spoken to you that in me you may not have peace in the world, but you have.
好，所以接下来你看这后面十三章以后，他都是讲明讲了。
And but then after chapter 13, everything was just plain sight.
那他又预告圣灵要来吗？
And he foretold that there will be the coming of the
Holy Spirit. 所以有关圣灵的保惠师的预言的那个应许，都是在十三章以后的。
And regarding any promise of the Holy Spirit, the Counselor will be after chapter 13.
好，那第十五章第十五节。
verse 15.
现在主跟门徒的关系也改了。
And so now the relationship between the Lord and the disciples.
第十五节。
Verse 15.
以后我不再称你们做仆人，因为仆人不知道主人所做的事，我乃称你们为朋友，因我从我父所听见的已经都告诉你们了。
No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends, for all things that I have learned from my father I have made known to you.
所以现在这个 门徒跟主耶稣的关系更亲近了，他是像朋友，无话不谈。
So the relationships between the disciple and the father is even more closer because they would engage in all conversations.
我从父所听到都告诉你们，是没有保留的。
And Jesus would pass all things that he has heard from the Father with no reservation.
那他讲了，他让我们都知道要干什么。
And he knew that whatever he said, we all know what we're supposed to do.
就是说，我们知道了，主耶稣告诉我们这么多真理，不是只是要让我们说觉得、哦、我很有知识，不是的。
From all the truth that Jesus told us, does not allow us to feel like we're very educated.
他要了解，让我们了解说，是他拣选了我们，要我们去。去结果子。
But we have to understand that he has chosen us and we have to bear fruits.
那要去结果子，其实也就是说我们要活出耶稣的生命，然后去继续主耶稣所留下这个救恩的工作。
So in order to bear fruits, we have to continuing the salvation assignment that's entrusted by God.
然后奉派你们结果，叫你们的果子长存。那这样子哈。使你们奉我的名无论向父求什么他就赐给你们，所以祷告就变得有功效了。
And so go and bear fruit that your fruit shall remain, that wherever you ask the Father in my name he may give you. So this way the prayer is effective.
所以祷告有功效是怎么来的？
And so what is the source of prayer being effective?
是因为我们跟主耶稣有很亲密的关系，像好朋友一样。
And because we have a very intimate relationship with Lord Jesus Christ, just like a best friend.
那我们能够明白、听得懂，而且愿意照主所说的、从父所告诉我们的这些话，我们都去做了。
And so that we can comprehend everything that was spoken to us, just like how Jesus understood the Father.
因为我们不是被拣选的，是他从万人中选出来的。
Because we're chosen by thousands of among thousands of people.
从世界里面拣出来，然后要我们去结果子。
We're chosen from the world in order for us to bear fruits.
那这个果子就是别人看得到的，这个是一种见证生命。
And so a fruit is something that other people can see and is a testimony.
那在这个情况下，你祷告就有功效。
So under this situation, that your prayer will be effective.
所以我们哦，今天如果没有在行真理，那只是一直说主啊，我祷告怎么没功效？那当然没功效啊。
And so if you're not practicing the truth today and you keep on praying, of course your prayer will be ineffective.
我们如果不行真理，那贪爱世界，然后遇到事情说传道帮我祷告，那你叫主耶稣给你祷告也没用。
If you don't practice the truth, then you can ask the pastor to pray for you, but it will be ineffective.
这不是谁祷告的问题。
This is not who prays.
是我们每一个人，我们到底怎么去行真理？是到底有没有了解说，哦，主耶稣把我选出来成为他的门徒，到底为什么？
But whether each and every one of us has practiced this truth and realized that why did Jesus Christ choose us?
如果我们只是还是贪爱世界，然后一直想要拥有更多。然后把神的事情、天父的事情都忘得一干二净，然后说：“我碰到困难，主啊，你听我祷告。”那你做梦。
And if we only care about the world and love the world and have forgotten all the teachings that Jesus wanted us, and when it's time for you to need His help and you pray, He would definitely not help you. You'll be daydreaming.
我们一定要看清楚主所讲的话，他是明说，他不是讲比喻的。
And so we have to really see clear of what Jesus is saying here. This is saying that stated in plain sight.
要真的去做主所讲的话，帮他维持那个跟主的良好关系。
And you really have to maintain this good relationship and follow His words.
他要去的地方说我们不能去。
And so anywhere that he's going, we cannot go.
现在还不能去，现在还不能去。
Now we cannot go.
也就是说，主耶稣要跟门徒分离了。
In other words, that Jesus will depart
from the disciples. 但是他去了，他还会来啊。
But after going, he will return back.
所以十四章他就说了。
So in chapter 14, he says.
第十四章第一节。
In chapter 14, verse 1.
你们现在心里不要忧愁。
And let not your heart be troubled.
你们信神也要信我。
You believe in God, believe also in me.
父的家里许多住处，若是没有，我早就告诉你了，对不对？我去是预备地方去的。
In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I would go to prepare a place for you.
到最后，我在哪里，你们也在哪里。
And if I go to prepare a place, I will be there, and you will be there.
所以在地上，主去哪里，我们去哪里嘛。
So on earth, anywhere does the Lord go, we will go.
那将来在天上。他在哪里，我们就在哪里。
So in the future, when he's in heaven, and of course we will be there.
我们如果在地上，
if we
不来教会，
if
we 不去做神的工，
We are on this world and not willing to work and labor for the Lord.
就说我死的时候我要回到主那边去，我要进天国。
And after you die, you tell yourself that you'll be going into heaven.
我们就没有跟从主的脚踪，请问你要怎样进到那里去？
You don't have the footsteps traces from following the Lord. I want to ask, how can you possibly go to heaven?
所以要看主耶稣他是做什么事，他走到哪里去。
And you can see where you have to see where Jesus walks and what he does.
他是存什么心
？And what kind of heart?
如果我们真的这样做，我们就很有把握。
And if we can do this way, and obviously we are very confident.
我们就真的胜过死亡。
And we will overcome death.
啊，这个就是第二段里面后面的信息。
And so this is the faith and recorded in the second passage.
这个就是大纲了哈。
This is the main summary.
那一到十二章里面哈
，and chapter 1 to 12.
我们之前有讲到这个这一篇这一段就是所谓的人子篇，就是人子在地上服事的过程。
And we have said that these are the chapters of the Son of Man. This is the process when Jesus, the Son of Man, was.
一开始就说道成肉身。
In the beginning, it was says that the Word formed into flesh.
哦，那这个问题哈，这个问题我们先等一下再说。我们现在先把昨天所的功课。现在看一下哈，不知道有没有做。
I wanted to ask everyone about their work, homework assignment. Have you done them yet?
啊，如果你有读第一章，把它读过以后
，and if you have read chapter one,
你就会发现有很多对主耶稣的称呼。
And you realize that there are many titles to Jesus.
一开始就说
，in the beginning,
第一章
，chapter one.
所以约翰福音第一章很重要。
So John chapter one is very important.
因为他一开始。
Because in the beginning,
他都介绍耶稣是谁。
There was an introduction of who Jesus is.
太初有道，这个太初其实 in the beginning, 这个跟创世纪一开头是一样的。
And so in the beginning, was the word. This is the same recording as the book of Genesis.
他现在说道就是神。
And it says that the word was with God. The word was God.
那这道太初就与神同在。
And the word was with God in the beginning.
哦，那所以。这个就是在这个世界还没有创造以前就存在的嘛。
And so, this existed before the creation of the world.
因为这个世界是神造的啊。
Because, God has created this world.
与神同在。
And abidance
with God. 是永存的，至存永存。
It's eternal.
哦，那所以这里这个道，它其实是拥有生命，生命在那里面。
And so the word has life within.
所以主会那个神用话一说有就有。
And so God spoke, and then
so,
it existed.
你看那个植物出来，然后那个什么星星、月亮出来，都有了。
Vegetations and plants and stars and moon.
那现在这个道成肉身，第十四节。
And the Word was God.
那所以住在我们当中。
And dwelling among us.
你可以亲眼看到、亲手摸到的。
And you can physically touch it and see it.
那就是在约翰一书一开头的时候，那个约翰他后来讲的。
And this is the same as the beginning of first.
这个生命的道，生命之道。
This is the word of life.
是亲手可以，你可以体验的。
And you can personally experience it.
那第十四节
，verse 14.
第一章十四节，所以说，正是我们见过他的荣光，正是父独生子的荣光。
And his glory, the glory as the only begotten Son of the Father.
其实这个地方啊，昨天你讲过。
And we have said this yesterday.
在原始的抄本里面，现在后来有很多，当然有很多不同的抄本，有很多不同的讲法。但其实，在原始的那个抄本里面，没有这个生，也没有子这个两个字。这都是我们翻译中文的时候把它放上去的。
And so in the original text, there's no such thing as the begotten or the.
不是用生的。
Or the son.
啊，也不是说儿子，因为你说用生的一定是儿子啊。
And so it's not they have not used this begotten
对不对
or son, and because it's born or what else you can born.
其实是变成的。
And actually it was formed.
所以是父独成的。
So it was formed by the father.
这跟第十八节是一样。
And so it's the same thing as verse 18.
父怀里的独生子，其实是父是独成的独成者。
The only
从父那边的独成者，独成的神。
So the only begotten Son who is in the bosom of the Father.
啊，所以其实这里都是，所以主耶稣是独一的了。
So Jesus is the only one.
那神是一的。
So God is one.
现在神 成为人呢。
Now God became man.
所以这叫独成的神呢。
And so this is the only
啊，是变成
begotten man.
带着肉体在我们地上。
And he has flesh in the world with us.
那因为这个儿子这个问题啊，是后来那个三位一体的神官啊，变成是他们的，就是说后来的主流的教会，当时都接受了这个三位一体的神官之后，后来在翻译圣经的时候哈，就有人说是偷改的，就是当时候是教会说了算呢、啊，所以翻译人觉得怎么好就下去了，那我们后面人都一直读嘛。
And because of the concept of Trinity, they later on used this translation. So later on, everybody used it.
因为最原始的抄本已经不见了，有很多的，就是最原始那个原稿不见，有很多人抄的，这个人抄，那个人抄，这抄的当中就有一些。可能就是不太同样的地方。
So the most original scroll was lost, and there were many written scrolls later on. Of course, they have differences.
我们并不是说圣经有错误哦，要搞清楚。
We're not saying that the Bible is wrong.
圣经没错误的。
And this the Bible would never.
因为圣经是神默示的，圣灵启示的。
Because the Bible is inspired by God.
道理一样都没有变的。
And the gospel and the word would never change.
所以现在是人在抄写的，所以人。有私心，有时候在写的时候，他会可能会故意漏掉，或者是把那个字，因为有时候一撇一点呢、哦，可能有跟没有意思就不一样了嘛。
And because the words were copied by men, so they can intentionally leave out something or add something.
哦，所以为什么说我们现在读圣经要去参考不同的那个资料跟一些工具的。
So why do we say that when we researching the Bible, we have to research different tools?
当然，其实我们读我们中文圣经都没问题的。
And of course, if we read the Chinese Bible, this
只要读清楚，你就知道，绝对不会失误的。
If you read it clearly, there will not be any mistakes.
好，读成者，然后第二十一节
，verse 21，
第一章二十一节
，chapter 1 verse 21，
二十一节，跟第四十应该是四十一节，二十一节吗？对，第一章二十一节嘛，哈。
Chapter 1 verse 21。
他问他，应该是读四十一节吧。
And actually, it's verse 41。
四十一节，弥赛亚就是基督，我们遇见基督了嘛，哈。
And we have found the Messiah, which is translated the Christ。
好，第二十四节说。
四十二还是二十四？
In
verse 24。
二十四节、啊，二十四节，那先知有没有？二十五节了，对不起，二十五节。
And verse 25。
哦，第二十五节。
Verse 25。
你既不是基督，不是以利亚，不是那先知，为什么施洗呢？那先知、啊。
And they asked him, "Why then do you baptize if you're not the Christ, nor the Elijah, nor the prophet?"
那个先知就是在《申命记》十八章里面一直预告摩西预告那个要来的那个先知，跟他一样。
So that prophet was it was already prophesized in Deuteronomy chapter 18, what Moses have said that prophet.
然后二十九节跟第三十六节就是神的羔羊，有没有
？And verse 29 and verse 36 will be the lamb of God.
所以耶稣是代罪的羔羊。
And Jesus is the sacrificial lamb.
这个第三十四节说神的儿子。
And verse 32, the Son of God. 三十四节
嘛。
Chapter 30, verse 34.
我看见了，就是这是神的儿子。
And this is the Son of God.
好，神的羔羊，神的儿子。
And the Lamb of God, the Son of God.
第三十八节。
Verse 38.
拉比，你在哪里住？拉比就是先生嘛。
And Rabbi, where are you staying? This means teacher.
就是老师哦。
That means Rabbi means teacher.
好，那。摩西律法上所写的那一位，第四十五节那里。
And verse 45, what's recorded in the Mosaic law.
腓力跟拿但也介绍了耶稣。
And this was introduced by Philip and Nathaniel.
好，第五十一节说，你看人子。
Verse 51 says the Son of Man.
这都是耶稣的 title， 他的称谓。
And so this is the title of Jesus.
这个就是从第一章里面看到这些称呼了。
And this is all recordings from chapter one.
这称呼在后面其实都会出现的。
And so you will see these recording appear later on.
那另外在第四章四十二节
，chapter 4 verse 42，
救世主
Savior.
他真是救世主。啊、
Indeed, he is the Savior of the world.
六章六十九节。
Chapter 6, verse 69.
神的圣者。
And the saints of God.
啊，是神的圣者。这些说，然后第后面很多就是有关于主啊，所以我们说主耶稣是主啊，这个都是他的称谓。
And there are many later on, which is the Lord.
好，我们超过时间，赶快休息，默祷。
And so let's pray in silence, take a break.